I'm Anita Wardlaw, and welcome to a fresh new day. I am so blessed to be sitting next to Dr. Loretta Blasingame. She is a dynamic woman of God. She has gone all around the world. She is an evangelist, a healing minister who has been in the ministry for many decades. She began as a teenager, and I have the opportunity to be sitting right here with her. And she has so much to share. Sit back and relax, and we're going to take you on a journey into the deeper things of God. Dr. Loretta, thank you for agreeing to come on a fresh new day.
Well, thank you for inviting me, and it is my pleasure to be here with you today.
Oh, it's so wonderful.
You're such a mighty woman of God, and it's just my honor to be here.
Thank you. Can you tell the audience how God called you when you were just a teenager?
Well, I got saved at 13, and one of my brothers had been praying for me to get saved. But my dad didn't want me to go to church with him because it was a Pentecostal church. And my dad was Baptist. He said, no, you can't go to that church. So my brother decided to go on a fast. Mm-hmm. He fasted 42 days on water. And he told God, I'm going to fast till you bring her to the kingdom. Mm. I don't know why. I think he really was the one God chose to preach. But then he went on this fast to get me in because he said, I thought you'd make the best preacher. So on the 42nd day, every day he'd come by, and Daddy said, no, she's not going. So on the 42nd day, Daddy said I could go, and I went. And the preacher was preaching how wonderful Jesus was and how he healed people and how he loved people. So I jumped up in the middle of the sermon, and I said, can you introduce me to this man that loves me so much? Mm. And so he led me to the Lord that night. So the next day, I asked Mom, I said, Mama, please tell Daddy I have to go to church tonight. Mm-hmm. And anyway, Daddy said I could go. And so the preacher was preaching on healing and how great Jesus loved to heal. So when I went home after the service, I sat down on the side of the bed, and I was taking my shoes off. And Jesus walked in my room, and he had a white Bible about this wide, but it was long. And he was holding it. He said, I'm calling you to preach this gospel. And if you'll preach just what's in this book and this gospel, I will heal people all over the world. Mm. And I was like, I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to say. And he said, and always remember, when you stand and preach, I'll always be at your right side. Oh. You may not see me, but I will always be there. And so I went, and I told the pastor the next day, we went to church. We went to a revival center. We had service every night for over a year.
Wonderful.
And I said, Pastor, Jesus came to me last night and told me I was to preach, and that he would heal people while I preached. And I said, can I preach Sunday morning? Can I get people healed Sunday morning after you get through with the sermon? And I said, I want to try it out. So he said, sure you can. So after he preached, I walked up and I took my Bible. And I said, Jesus said in this Bible, he healed them all. And I said, he's here today to heal everyone that's here. But I had said to the pastor, can you bring me somebody that's dying? Can we get somebody in the house that's not going to live? I need somebody dying because I wanted to try it out. You know, at 13, you wouldn't try everything out. So anyway, they brought this lady, and the doctors had given her up. She needed a new heart, but they were not doing heart transplants then. And so I laid hands on her, and I said, God, give her a brand new heart, and let the doctors verify it with all of their scans and x-rays. So she went back to the doctor, and she came back the next night, and she said, I had the scans today, and I have a brand new heart.
Praise
God. And the doctors
God.
Are just amazed. And I knew then I heard like the voice of God that said, this is the beginning of your worldwide healing ministry.
Oh, that's wonderful.
So every Sunday after he preached, I'd pray for the sick for a year and a half.
Mm-hmm.
And then after I did that, every Sunday, I teamed up with a couple, and they had a tent.
Mm-hmm.
And we did tent meetings. They would preach, and you know how tent meetings are. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Well, we had like 700, 800, 1,000.
Mm.
And they'd fill the tent, stand outside. And then the Lord said, there's so many that needs a miracle.
Mm-hmm.
All you have to do is just speak the word.
Wow.
If you speak the word, I'll do the healing.
Mm.
So I would just stand and speak the word like Jesus said. I said,
mm-hmm.
God is healing with cancer. You're being healed now. Go back to the doctor. The doctor will verify it.
Mm-hmm.
If you need a new heart, God will put a new heart in you right now. All you have
mm-hmm.
to do is just lift your hand to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I'm going to call that heart in your body.
Mm-hmm.
And I started doing that. And then I hooked up with another couple that did tent
uh-huh.
meetings. And so I was going all over. And especially on the weekends, we'd
mm-hmm.
set up like crusades.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord was doing phenomenal miracles just when I was 13. And then I kept doing that. And so now I've been doing it over 50 years.
Oh, that's just fantastic.
And he's still the same.
He is. It says, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. And Jesus said in his word that we are not to live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. And that's the Holy Bible. So we know when we fill up on the Holy Bible, mm-hmm. there's authority in the word of God. There's authority when you speak the word. Now, out there, you might have said, how can you just speak the word and someone be healed? You have to believe the word. Dr. Loretta believes the word, and there's authority in the word of God when you believe the word. There's always authority in it, but the Lord said we have to believe. If we believe that he is, and he is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him, then he will bless us. So we have to just put our trust in someone that made us and is so much greater than us. And Dr. Loretta, you've had to trust God throughout this whole journey.
Mm-hmm.
And you've gone through things and come up victorious every single time. Isn't that right?
Yes. And I've had a few challenges on the way. But when I got in church, then the preacher started talking about the gifts of the Spirit.
Right.
And the Holy Spirit.
Uh-huh.
And so I said, well, I need that too, don't I? And he said, you sure do.
Mm-hmm.
And so I would go every night, and they'd lay hands on me to get the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And because I wanted those gifts to be manifested. Well, I was so bashful, I just had the hardest time receiving the Holy Spirit. Because they would lay hands on me.
Uh-huh.
I was really bashful. I'm not today, I can tell you that. I've covered the world almost now. And so one night, as a pastor, can I just go over there and get in that corner all by myself?
Mm-hmm.
And would you tell the ladies not to come and pet? You know how they say, pet you? And I said, can I just get in the corner by myself?
Mm-hmm.
And so I went over in that corner, and this is what I said. And I was honest with God. I said, Lord, you know, I've been trying to get your Spirit
mm-hmm.
so the gifts would really be manifested
mm-hmm.
for a year and a half. And you haven't filled me, so if you don't fill me tonight, I'm not going to ever ask you again. Because
mm-hmm.
I was on it every night. Lord, I need to be filled. Lord, I
mm-hmm.
need to be filled with your Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So I over in my corner, all of a sudden, the Spirit of the Lord came upon me. And God filled me, and when he filled me, he gave me those gifts.
Oh, that's
so
wonderful.
So I got in the Bible, and I read in the Bible, and I know you know this. You know
mm-hmm.
more than I know.
Oh, I didn't know about that.
In 1 Corinthians in the 12th chapter, it says, but the manifestation of the Spirit, that's the Holy Spirit,
mm-hmm.
is given to every man to profit withal.
Mm-hmm.
So God gives us that anointing and the Spirit to profit people.
Mm-hmm.
For to one is given by the Spirit the word of wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
And you have that gift, honey. And to another, the word of knowledge. And you have that gift.
Mm-hmm.
Many of you watching have that gift. And by the same Spirit. And to another, faith. By the same Spirit. Now, the gift of faith is different than just saying, I have faith for you
mm-hmm.
to be healed.
Right.
The gift of faith, when I'm ministering, I know exactly when that gift comes up on
mm-hmm.
me. I will have faith like a I can do anything. Mm-hmm. The Holy Spirit of God in me can do anything. Mm-hmm. And all I have to do is speak it. When I was 15 and the Lord came to me, the Lord said, all you will ever have to do is speak it, mm-hmm. and I'll perform it. Mm-hmm. When I stand, and I always have a lot of people with cancer, mm-hmm. I quote this scripture. I always quote this verse because mm-hmm. I want people to understand the gifts are being manifested. Mm-hmm. The gift of faith is being manifested. Mm-hmm. The workings of miracles. Mm-hmm. And when I quote that, I say, now, mm-hmm. some of you need hearts. I call upon the Spirit of the living God to create hearts. Mm-hmm. And I know exactly when that gift starts moving in, mm-hmm. in the congregation. And then I'll say, some of you need an eye. Mm-hmm. God is creating that eye right now. Mm-hmm. See, I get the word of knowledge, but I know the gift is going to mm-hmm. them to heal them. Mm-hmm. And one night I was in, I forget where I was. I traveled so much. Mm-hmm. I walked down the aisle and the Lord said, stop. That was the Holy Spirit that spoke. Mm-hmm. He said, this woman to your left, because mm-hmm. I was going to the pulpit,
right. mm-hmm.
has a sister in New Zealand dying, and they say she's going to die tonight mm-hmm. with cancer mm-hmm. of the lungs. Mm-hmm. You speak the word right now, and you tell this woman, mm-hmm. he said her name is Luann, mm-hmm. tell her Luann's being healed right mm-hmm. now in New Zealand of cancer. Mm-hmm. And I spoke it, and God did it just like that.
Praise God.
Because the Holy Spirit moved. I think I was in Alabama. That's where mm-hmm. I was. From Alabama to New Zealand, when mm-hmm. the Holy Spirit manifested that mm-hmm. word, she was healed on the spot.
Amen.
She's still healed.
Praise God.
And that's why the Lord has you on this TV program, to speak to this audience that needs the miracles, that needs encouraging, that needs God to touch them mm-hmm. to live. Mm-hmm. You know, there's people watching right now that is probably going to die in a few days.
And that's God.
But you're here to see to it to get healed today.
Yes. Yes.
And the Holy Spirit is with us. He mm-hmm. came with us. We mm-hmm. brought him. I don't go anywhere until right. I say, Holy Spirit, are you ready to come? And then he manifests the gift of wisdom. He manifests the word of knowledge. And the gift of faith. Now, I work a lot in the word of knowledge, because when I go to a place, I don't know what they need. Mm-hmm. But the Holy Spirit will, from the platform I do it, and they're healed in the audience. Mm-hmm. He'll say there's someone. A lot of times, one time I called everybody in the house by name.
Praise God.
And I didn't know that this place didn't really believe in the Holy Spirit. And here I'm up calling everybody by name. But the Holy Spirit will do whatever he has to do mm-hmm. to get people healed. You know, mm-hmm. I've discovered that. Mm-hmm. He will do whatever has to be done mm-hmm. to get a person healed and touched. Mm-hmm. And so God just gave me their names. He said, tell so-and-so, I'm healing them of so-and-so. And That kicked off a revival that mm-hmm. ran for I don't know how many weeks, over a month. But the Lord was working through his Spirit. Remember in the Bible where it says the Spirit of the Lord God came upon Jesus?
Yes.
And then he told the disciples, go to the upper room and pray and tarry till you be filled
yes.
with the Spirit of God from on high. Mm-hmm. And they went to the upper room and they prayed. I think it'll take them a few days to get together. But when they got together and that anointing began to come, God filled them
yes.
with the Spirit. And they went out and people was healed. People was healed when they walked by them. Mm-hmm. And when we go to our meetings, we don't limit the Holy Spirit.
Right.
People say, we know when you're in the building, people mm-hmm. start getting healed. Mm-hmm. Now they start getting healed during the day while I'm praying.
Yes.
Because usually I pray all day before I get to the building. Mm-hmm. And the Holy Spirit starts those miracles then. Mm-hmm. And the Holy Spirit's performing miracles right now
yes.
in your TV program.
He is.
While they're watching. Mm-hmm. People are being healed. Mm-hmm. Someone just got healed of lung cancer watching your program, mm-hmm. the Lord just told me. So the Holy Spirit comes to manifest these gifts. And so I think it'd be a good thing for everyone to just say, Holy Spirit, fill me with the
yes,
gifts.
Yes, I agree.
Fill me. Use me. Mm-hmm. Right now, people need to be healed more mm-hmm. than any time I know of. Mm-hmm. And then the word of prophecy, that's when you give a word, you know, that hasn't happened yet. And then the Lord says there's a gift of speaking in tongues and people interpret. Mm-hmm. And I've been around a lot of great preachers because I've been at this so long, so You know, I knew all those great preachers. We had Jack Coe and all that, mm-hmm. Allen and all them. Mm-hmm. And they had phenomenal miracles. But what I want to say today is she has come your way with this TV program, and God is the same. Mm-hmm. All the great things God used to do through the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit, she's here on television to bring you that anointing, to bring you that life, to give you life. Some of you, the doctors, have given a bad report, but she's here today to give you a good report, because mm-hmm. Jesus is the same.
Yes.
God made this program available. Mm-hmm. She's made herself available. I came today and made myself available just to back her up on this program to get you healed. Mm-hmm. And we're going to pray for you in a moment. Mm-hmm. But before we pray, can I show them some testimonies?
Yes, please.
I have a book out. This is my second edition. And it's called, Is Anybody Up There? I have my experience that when I died in my early 20s, I died. They pronounced me dead of two heart attacks. But Jesus took me to heaven and said, I'm not through with you yet.
Yes.
He gave me a new heart. He gave me a tour of heaven. I got to go in my mansion. I got to go see my grandmother. I got to see my little baby brother.
Tell them about your mansion.
My mansion, I went in and it was gold. It was huge. It looked as big as the whole earth. And I turned to Jesus and I said, I don't have any furniture in my mansion. I had just gone to my grandmother's mansion and her mansion was full of furniture. Mm-hmm. It was all gold and it looked like pure gold. And it was huge. Her mansion, though, wasn't as big as mine. And I said, Jesus, my grandmother had furniture. And he says, well, you're not living up here yet. Mm-hmm. When you come back to live, your mansion will be full.
Wasn't your time yet.
It wasn't time yet. So everybody wonders, am I going to have a mansion? Yes. You serve God and work for God, you're going to have a mansion.
Yes.
And the more you work for God and do for God, the bigger it'll be and the greater it'll be. Mm-hmm. And you can live in that mansion. And I'll tell you something else. Jesus walks all over heaven. He was walking into different mansions. Mm-hmm. And then I saw a group off to the side, and they were doing like this. And I thought, well, that kind of looks strange. What are they doing? I said, Jesus, what are they doing? And he said, oh, he said, they're being taught how to worship God.
Right.
You cannot come in the presence of God until you learn mm-hmm. how to worship God. Isn't mm-hmm. that something? So mm-hmm. we need to really get on that worshiping
like
God
that,
here.
Because we are to honor God.
Yes.
And, you know, sometimes it's grievous when you hear people not maybe saying a bad word, but they get familiar. And God is God. Uh-huh. And he's worthy of our honor. He's worthy of our praise.
Yes,
and
he
I
is.
Know you love to praise God.
Oh, I surely do. I surely do. I'm a little bit quieter than most folks, but sometimes when I get people in a praise in an auditorium, it's like I hear the wind of the Spirit of God.
Yeah,
I know exactly when it comes in, mm-hmm. and I've got everybody in an atmosphere to receive mm-hmm. whatever God wants to bring them. Mm-hmm. And we have people not only healed in our auditoriums, we have people now, because I went on a fast one time. I did 40-day fast on water, mm-hmm. and I did 5 right back to back. And I said, God, when I minister, will you heal people all over the world? Because mm-hmm. I can't travel all over the world mm-hmm. to everybody, but I wanted everybody healed.
Yes.
So I did those fasts, and so when I'm like even in Dallas mm-hmm. or Minneapolis, people are being healed overseas.
Yes.
And we get the report. So the Holy Spirit is not limited.
Right.
Like, even this TV program yes. you're doing today, the Spirit of the Lord is moving out. God
yes.
is moving you out through television.
Praise God.
God is going to enlarge you. I see a lot of different stations.
Praise
God. And I see
God.
You going to stations and doing live interviews. Mm-hmm. The Spirit of the Lord is upon you, and the Spirit was given, the Bible says, without measure. Mm-hmm. See, we can't measure God to Minneapolis today, mm-hmm. or Burnsville, or wherever this mm-hmm. show goes. Mm-hmm. When this goes out, it goes out in the atmosphere. Mm-hmm. And you know, when I was 4 years old, I was telling some preachers, we're going to have live TV.
Uh-huh.
And they said, oh, we don't have TV. I said, we're going to have TV, and I'm going to give you a scripture. I found a scripture in the Old Testament that said, you shall speak across the lines.
Oh, praise
when I
God.
Read that, God said, that's television.
Praise
we didn't
the
have
Lord.
TV then. But I was announcing to everybody we would. What do we do today? we're speaking across the lines, just like the Bible says.
Yes.
And you can't limit that.
No.
This program goes out. The Spirit of God is going out, not only in this state, in other states, mm-hmm. because the Holy Spirit and the angels of God and the anointing of God is picking it up and taking it to uh-huh. whosoever needs it.
Yes.
So don't ever show up on this program and think you're not going mm-hmm. worldwide
yeah.
because the Holy Spirit knows.
Mm-hmm.
God, a lot of times, will let people overseas see us doing a TV program.
Mm-hmm.
They will begin to see you doing a TV program.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll speak the word and they'll go, we had a vision. Mm-hmm. We had a dream. Mm-hmm. There was a woman. She had a TV program.
Mm-hmm.
And she was speaking life to us.
Mm-hmm.
And we got saved.
Mm-hmm.
So we can never limit God.
Mm-hmm.
We can never put a limit on the word of God.
That's right.
Because he's all power and all knowing.
Mm-hmm.
And nothing is impossible with God.
Yes, nothing.
Now I teach even kids that one as soon as they yes. can talk. Nothing is impossible with God. We
yes.
had a little group of children in
uh-huh.
the program last night in mm-hmm. the service.
Yes, we did.
I went back, I shook every hand,
mm.
and I said, nothing is impossible
yes.
with God.
Yes.
And they had to leave early, but when I said that, that was my word to get my hand in theirs.
Yes.
Because when I did, under my breath, I
yes.
said, heal them, Lord.
Yeah.
They all had a little challenge. They
yes.
all needed a miracle.
Yes.
I gave a scripture, but under my breath, I was
yes.
saying, heal them, Jesus.
Yes.
Make them whole.
Yes.
Heal their minds.
Yes.
And take them to the top.
Yes.
God knows where to put you, and God knows when he puts us there, we're anointed.
Yes.
And when we're anointed, you have to take advantage of
yes.
it. You have to take advantage of this time that's going out today with your TV program.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to let you pray in a minute. I'm going to quit talking. But I wanted to show you a couple of testimonies. When I came to Minneapolis the first time, L.D. Kramer brought me in.
Mm-hmm.
He said, Dr. Loretta, will you go to the hospital? There's a little boy, they're going to pull the plugs on.
Mm.
So we rushed to the hospital and I went in. They'd taken all the equipment off of this little
uh-huh.
boy. He was, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 months
mm-hmm.
old. Just a little tiny
mm-hmm.
fellow. His name is Joey Peterson. And when they took everything off, I laid hands on him and I said, Holy Spirit, do your work.
Yes.
From the top of his little head to the soles of his feet, recreate everything he
yes.
needs. Take all this cancer out of this little body, and Lord, use him mightily.
Mm-hmm.
God healed him on the spot. They took him home that night.
Mm-hmm.
It was that night or early the next morning.
Mm-hmm.
And he was totally healed.
Uh-huh.
Now he's 24 years old, lives still in Minneapolis.
Oh.
And he owns 2 car lots.
Wonderful.
And so,
wonderful.
And that's my little Joey right there.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's so wonderful. Praise God.
So I put his testimony in here.
Do you have the one about the little baby that got the new eyes?
And the little baby, oh, I told you about it. I'm going to put her in my next book.
Okay.
It was a little girl. I was in... where was I? I was in California.
Mm-hmm.
I was going, I was in Minneapolis. And
okay.
I was going back to California.
Uh-huh.
And I believe that's the way it was. And God spoke to me. And Ann was going to Mobile, my assistant.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord said, have Ann to get you a ticket
mm-hmm.
fast.
Mm-hmm.
And you go to Mobile with Ann.
Mm.
And so I said, Ann, grab me a ticket right quick. And she went over and got me a ticket. And we.
Praise God.
Here's the word he gave me. There's a little girl that has lost... he said, St. Jude is going to take both of her eyes out because she's blind.
Mm.
And they had it all set up to do it in
mm-hmm.
a month. And he said, I'm going to have you to set up a meeting.
Mm-hmm.
You tell Joey, that was my promoter
mm-hmm.
over there, you tell
mm-hmm.
Joey to find that baby and bring that baby in the morning. I'm going to give her 2 new eyes.
Uh-huh.
So I had to call Mobile. I had to get Joey. He started crying. He said, Loretta, I have the little baby in my
uh-huh.
arms right now. And she, I think, was five months old.
Uh-huh.
And we're doing a fundraising for
mm-hmm.
her and the family. And I said, Joey, find me a church in the morning and tell the pastor I need the whole service so I can set the atmosphere for the healing.
Yes.
He asked one of our friends, a lady, and she said, sure. And we had her church. And so I started the service, and I stood there, and I began to preach just a little bit. And the Lord said, the father didn't tell the mother about bringing the baby. The baby's not here. I said, oh my gosh. I said, well, the ushers, go over there to that house and you talk to the mother about that baby over here. And the father forgot to tell her.
Oh.
So they got the baby dressed and they rushed in, and I went on preaching about healing, and all of a sudden the Lord said, the baby's in the house. Mm. And he said, tell them to bring the baby down front. I've already given her two nights. And so they brought the baby down front, and they was holding her. And I looked at her, and she looked up and did like this to me. I knew she had those eyes then.
She couldn't have done
that. Yes. She couldn't have done that. And God had given this baby, her name is Layla Havens, two new eyes.
Beautiful.
Beautiful blue eyes, prettiest eyes I've ever seen. And so I said to the mother and father, I said, she has her new eyes.
Uh-huh.
And so anyway, I laid hands on her. And that was 7 years ago.
Oh, you showed me a picture.
And she calls me Mimi. I've been hands-on for 7 years with this little girl.
That's beautiful.
And the family. And she got healed because, not because of me, but because the pastor opened up the church. We got the ticket. My assistant saw to it. I got ready real quick. When I got there, this lady said, I'll put you on the hotel. And a lot of people got involved. It takes involving, you know.
But you had to obey.
I obeyed.
And you did your part. Just like you told us, we have to do immediate obedience.
That's right.
And that's how God can work through us.
And that's how God works. And that's how God got that little girl. Now, if God had not had done that, St. Jude had it set up that they were going to take both of her little eyes out because she couldn't see out of either one of them.
God did it supernaturally.
But God did it supernaturally. Now, her daddy, when he was, I think, 4 years old, had cancer, and they did take one of his eyes out. Her daddy only has one eye. I said, oh, no, this child God is talking to me about is not going to lose our little eyes.
That's right.
So that's one thing we do. And then I was at a mission one time where it was one of the missions they used for the outpouring of the Azusa Street outpouring.
Oh, wonderful.
And this lady was in the altar.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord said, that lady's got cancer of the breast. Go up there and lay hands on her and tell her I'm healing her. So I did. I can be brave when God
says. Yes.
I went over. Her name is Patricia Blake, and I laid hands on her. God instantly healed her. She's 84 now.
Wow.
I just talked to her a couple of days ago. She lives in Phoenix.
Oh, praise God.
And I'm going to fly over to see her. And she's still healed. And that was in 1980.
Praise God.
At a mission.
Praise God.
One of the missions that they use for the outpouring.
Mm.
This lady was kind of interesting. They were from, I think, China. And he came over here to go to school to one of our universities in Dallas. And one day my friend came by. She's Lady Jeannie LaCouse, or Lionel LaCouse Witta. She came by my house and she said, I want to check your blood pressure. And I said, you're not going to check my blood pressure. We're on a visit. Get something cold to drink and go eat. She said, I want to check your blood pressure. I said, okay, we'll do it in a hurry so we can get out of here. She checked my blood pressure and it was extremely high, really high. She says, Dr. Loretta, I hate to tell you, but I've just called the ambulance. She said, you know, when I went to the bathroom, I called the ambulance and I'm taking you to the hospital. I said, I can't go to the hospital. She said, you're going to the hospital. I'm going with you. They take me in the hospital, put me in ICU. Well, I'm in here and I'm just going. I said to God, don't we have something confused here? I'm supposed to be in here praying for the sick, not in the bed. So pretty soon they brought this Chinese lady. This lady. They put her in a bed and she starts crying. And she cried and she cried. Finally, I said to Lady Jeannie LaCouche, take these needles out of me. I think I know what my job is here.
God just got you there.
I got out of the bed and I went over to her and I said, honey, why are you crying? She said, well, they just told me I have cancer and I only have about 3 days to live and I have two little children. My husband's over here studying to be a minister. And I said, is that all? She says, isn't that bad enough? I said, honey, do you believe in Jesus? She said, sure, he's going to be a minister. I said, you believe in healing? She says, I don't know. I said, well, I do. And I mean, I took the floor. And I said, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to lay hands on you. The power of God's going to fall on you. And God's going to heal you of this cancer. And you're going to live. And about that time, her husband came and he said, what are you doing? I said, I'm getting your wife healed. He said, you're doing what? He says, well, we don't believe in that. I said, that doesn't matter. That's not going to help hint of my faith. I do believe in it. And your wife's being healed of cancer. And I mm-hmm. said, you're here going to college, but you think you're going back to China, but you're not. You're going to stay in Dallas and get your degree. And you're going to get a church, and you're going to start praying for the sick.
Wow.
He says, I am. I said, you surely are. When I get her healed, I'll lay hands on you and release that power.
Mm-hmm.
So God healed her right on the spot.
Praise God.
They released her the next day. He stayed in Dallas, and he has a church right now in Dallas, and he's praying for the sick.
Oh, that is wonderful. That is wonderful.
So that's how I got that miracle.
Oh,
so when
I
God
love
puts
it.
Me somewhere, I always know there's a reason.
Yes, absolutely.
So I went in to Phoenix one day. My friend called, and I went to conduct the funeral service for
yes.
one of my best friends,
uh-huh.
a little boy we got promoted to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, she's in the White House right now. It's Eve Nunes.
Okay.
And she heads up the prayer in the White House. It
oh.
was her little boy.
Uh-huh.
So I flew in, and she said, Dr. Loretta, there's a little baby at the hospital, and they're fixing to pull the plugs on. Could I take you to the hospital?
Mm-hmm.
I said, sure, Eve, let's hurry.
Mm-hmm.
So, boy, she drove real fast. We ran to the hospital. So we go in, and the doctor pulls the plugs on this little baby. And I said, Doctor, are you through doing what you're going to do? And he said, yes. I said, please leave the room. I'm going to do what I do best. So he left the room, and I went over, and I laid hands on this little girl.
Mm.
And here's what God did. Oh, God did it so wonderful.
Mm.
He gave her two new eyes because
oh,
she was blind.
Praise God.
He gave her a new brain
because
she was brain dead, and that's why they was pulling the plugs.
Oh.
And her little heart had deteriorated, and God gave her a new heart.
Praise God.
And she's still living today.
That is beautiful. That is beautiful.
So that took me about 5 minutes to get that done.
Mm.
I am just a carrier like you. You're carrying Jesus today. You're carrying the anointing and the power and the Spirit of God today to get these people healed. There's people watching.
Yes.
And they're going, we don't know what to do.
That's right.
Well, we're dying. What do we do?
Mm-hmm.
Then all of a sudden they go over and they turn that
mm-hmm.
knob.
Mm-hmm.
And God sees to it, they turn that knob.
Mm-hmm.
And then you come on
mm-hmm.
and you say, I'm here mm-hmm. and God is going to heal you.
Yes.
Today I'm here with my precious sister.
Mm.
And I can verify with her God mm-hmm. is going to heal
yes.
you. She's going
yes.
to say a prayer in a minute, whenever
mm-hmm.
she decides or
mm-hmm.
whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever we do next,
mm-hmm.
we're going to do it for you.
Mm-hmm.
We're here today for
mm-hmm.
you to
mm-hmm.
bring Jesus to
mm-hmm.
you.
Mm-hmm.
We're bringing the Jesus that will bring you life,
mm-hmm.
give you hope, and bring healing. That's
yes.
what he did.
Yes.
He went about, the Bible says, healing them all. It's
yes.
right here in the book. He went about healing them all. All.
Mm-hmm.
So today they'll all be healed. And I'm
yes.
going to let you take it over now. I've talked enough.
Well, I am so honored to have Dr. Loretta here. And God has anointed her especially. God's anointed me, but God's anointed her especially. And she's a specialist in healing. It's God that does the work. But your job is simply to sit back and believe. Now, you might not even know Jesus. I'm going to lead you in a little prayer. And if you believe in your heart what you say, I can guarantee you, you'll have a fresh new day in Jesus. And then I'm going to let Dr. Loretta pray for healing. I might include that in the prayer, but she's going to pray as well. And before I do, I believe there's someone out there who's feeling so frustrated. Even before you turned on this television set, you were thinking maybe it wasn't worth living another day. But I'm here to tell you, God has a plan for you. God has a plan for you, and you have many days ahead. And you're going to live. You're going to live and not die. I say that to you right now. You will live and not die. God is a God of life. Now, if you don't know what we're talking about, we love Jesus, we know Jesus, just say, Jesus, make yourself real to me. Here I am. Forgive me for anything I've ever done wrong. I want to know you. And you know what? God will take it from there. Because Jesus came and he paid the price for all of our mistakes, and he also paid the price for us to be well and healed. So, I'm going to let Dr. Loretta pray for your healing right now.
Thank you. I titled my book, Is Anybody Up There? Because in my 20s, I did die of two heart attacks. And while I was dead, I took a trip to heaven, which is in my book. This is my second print. And when I went to heaven, the Lord said, I want you to speak the word and tell them to believe. And I will heal them all, just what you said. Mm-hmm. God confirmed that to me face to face in heaven. Mm-hmm. I will heal them all. Mm-hmm. So she has just told you, all you have to do is just simply believe. It's just so simple. Just, you don't have to have been in the church a long time. There's a lot of you that will be healed today and you've never even received the Lord.
Right, exactly.
I have probably 50% of the mm-hmm. people gets healed in my ministry mm-hmm. and meetings don't even know God.
That's right.
I go overseas a lot and mm-hmm. I walk the ground and people are healed. They don't mm-hmm. know, they don't understand anything. They don't know anything.
In fact, if you don't believe, we're believing for you.
Oh, that's a good word.
Because God has many ways to heal you. You can believe for yourself, but we can believe for you.
For you. We will work on faith.
So we believe you're going to be healed. You can lay hands on the sick. You can read the word and be healed. You can hear from God directly. But you might not even have said the prayer I said with you. You may not know Jesus at all. You might say, well, let's just see what you can do. Well, I tell you what, we believe God's going to touch you. Not only do we believe it, we know it.
We know it. We know it. We're going to speak the word and we're going to come in agreement, right? And the Holy Spirit, move through this airwaves, move through this television. Yes. Lord, we speak them healed right now. The Lord has shown me there's someone dying with emphysema. Mm-hmm. You're 42 years old and your name is Lucy. And God is healing you right now, Lucy. Mm-hmm. In the name mm-hmm. of Jesus. And there's a man named Joel. You've got cancer, mm-hmm. prostate cancer. Joel, God's mm-hmm. healing you right yeah. now in the name of Jesus. And Carrie, you're being healed.
Yeah.
You're being healed. Every person watching this program today, I'm telling you, we have them healed in yes. our crusades. We have them all.
Yes.
She gets them healed. Just simply believe and reach out and say, God, thank you for my miracle.
Yes.
Just thank you for my miracle. I receive it.
Yes.
Just reach up and receive it. Just take it. Mm-hmm. And I tell people in the crusades, just reach out and take whatever you
yes.
need. Just take it. It's just yes. that simple. Jesus
yes.
is walking your way
yeah.
today through
yeah.
our broadcast. Jesus
yeah.
is coming to you
yes.
to heal you.
Mm-hmm.
And the Bible says he healed them all.
Yeah.
Not one of you today
mm-hmm.
will he miss. He
yes.
knows your name. He knows your address. He
yes.
knows exactly where you are.
Yes.
So be healed right now.
Mm-hmm.
We release the power
yes.
and the anointing of
be
God
healed.
To come out across these airwaves.
Yes.
Be healed.
Yes.
Be raised up.
Yes.
And all of you who need a job,
yes.
get a job.
Yes.
I will release that.
Yes.
The jobs will come to you in the name
yes.
of Jesus.
Yes.
And there's four that they've already said they're going to take your home. No, they're not going
That's
to
right.
take those homes.
Mm-hmm.
I speak a way
mm-hmm.
to keep your home and to pay mm-hmm. those homes off in
yes.
the name of Jesus.
Yes. Be encouraged. Be encouraged and know that this is the beginning of a fresh new day. Make it a fresh new day in Jesus.
And please contact her and let her know what God did in your life and through
yes.
this program. Please do it.
Yes.